Tournament. Here we're having our first game in Division D, Gladstone versus Burnt Creek Silver. My name is Alex Nguyen, and I'm joined by my co-caster.
Hi, I'm Jonathan Ramirez from UBC. I'm excited to be here. Let's get this game going.
And we do see our first band coming out from Gladstone. It looks like the Volibear band. He's very effective in the jungle, but also as a top laner.
And then the Katarina band coming out. Big burst damage in the early game as well as the late. Tends to catch people off guard as well in the mid lane. Now the Malphite coming out too. This classic ban, full AP Malphite, kind of having a resurgence in the jungle.
Yeah, and he is very strong after he gets that level 6, able to change the way players play around the map. They have to be more careful in the lanes. They have to have deeper wards to see that Malphite coming before he's even entered the lane.
Yeah, and ever since the inclusion of Predator, he's been pretty big menace in that jungle with that high-paced ganking potential.
Yeah. And let's see what this second ban looks like. The Tryndamere banned away from Gladstone. Tryndamere, very lane bully-esque champion, able to snowball really well. Yasuo ban coming out as well. Another of the very snowbally champions banned away.
Yeah, Yasuo, big lane presence as well, along with the Katarina. So both these champions are now out of the game. Interesting to see what they will pick in the mid lane. And now looking for the third and final band of this cycle for Burnt Creek Silver.
Let's see what they decide to ban away.
Looks like not any ban at all. Maybe they got that confidence. Don't need another ban.
All right, looks like
and Teemo insta-locked here for Gladstone. Interesting pick.
Teemo, very strong champion in the late game. With that blind, able to just negate most AD carries in the game that are auto attack based. So
I mean,
we'll see.
recently picked as like a counter pick, but first picking it here, maybe a lot of confidence in the top or mid lane. Now Pantheon, possibly picking into a Teemo.
Pantheon, very strong early game, actually. One of the strongest early game champions in the game right now. Has that empowered W, could go press the attack, and that's a buttload of damage right there for in like 2 seconds. So
and now we wonder, will Pantheon go against Teemo in the top lane, or will Teemo go mid and force a different pick from Gladstone?
Yeah, and I really like the Pantheon pick from Burnt Creek Silver. As you can flex him, he can go top, he can go mid, he can go jungle, however such one he just locked in by Burnt Creek Silver. So I really want to see if they can flex this Pantheon based on the picks by Gladstone.
Echo coming out now for Gladstone, possibly going in the jungle, of course, with that new smite.
Yeah, and Echo, with that buff on his W, the 2 second stun, it's really deadly. If you get caught in that, you're probably going to die to an Echo gank.
Now Morgana coming out. Either could be in the support or the mid lane.
Yeah.
And
Morgana, very, very good against the Sejuani, the Pantheon, able to negate a lot of their CC with the Black Shield. We'll see what Burnt Creek do to counterpick this Morgana. It doesn't look like they're looking to show their bot lane just yet. The Ahri comes out in the draft.
And now the second cycle of bans coming out. Burnt Creek Silver having the first choice. After not banning another thing, we can only wonder what they'll do for their second cycle of bans. Mm-hmm. Maybe they'll wait out the clock again and ban nothing again. Okay, it looks like a Vayne coming out. Smart, as Vayne has a pretty high late game presence currently in the meta. And yeah, now let's see what Gladstone returns with.
And just so you guys know, Burnt Creek does have the counterpick option. They do choose last, so I want to see if they're going to counterpick the AD carry or they're going for the last pick support. And it looks like Gladstone looking for the Sivir ban. Sivir, a very late game champion as well. You farm till 500 minions and you just take over the game.
Yeah, Sivir with pretty high wave clear and big pressure later in the game. Early laning phase, though, not so much. And now the LeBlanc coming out for Burnt Creek Silver. And last ban will be Ezreal. So a big ADC ban here as they haven't revealed it. And looks like the Varus is going to be coming out for Burnt Creek.
And I do like the Varus pick. With that ultimate, able to stop an echo gank if it hits. Really just a strong AD carry for disengages or even engages. Looks like the Draven hover for Gladstone. We'll see if they lock it in. They do lock in the Draven.
And now last pick here for Gladstone. We can only wonder. Ooh. Okay, a Vladimir.
Interesting summoner spell choice from this Draven here.
And it looks like Leona coming in from Burn Creek, perhaps?
They're thinking about it. They're not sure, though, going into that Morgana with the spell shield might be an interesting pick here.
Yeah, and I do see the Draven. He does have the Cleanse Ghost. I'm not sure if he'll keep those. And Leona does come in.
And now let's see if that Teemo will stay top against Pantheon. Switch has come out. Morgana looking to be support. And the Teemo is indeed staying top into that Pantheon.
Mm-hmm. And
Teemo, pretty dominant early game against that champion.
And I love the difference in drafts between these teams. We see Burn Creek Silver going for that heavy team fight, heavy CC team, looking for picks with the Charm, with the Pantheon W, Sejuani Ultimate, while we have Gladstone on the other side. Very slippery team. They have a lot of burst potential, a lot of snowbally late game champions. And I want to see how this game turns out between the difference in drafts.
Yeah, and the other thing I noticed is that all Teemo, Vladimir, and Morgana all have Ignites. There is not a teleport on this team, so their late-game map presence might be a little lackluster in comparison to the Pantheon with the teleport coming out, but if that early game is just as dominant with the Teemo, it might not matter.
And we do see Draven, actually, not going for the heal, or the flash.
Rolling out with the Ghost and Cleanse.
Alright. And I believe it is intermission. Okay.
Intermission?
Yeah, I think so. There's a fire that burns inside. It's an instinct that never lies. The target's tattooed between our eyes.
As a child, you would wait and watch from far away. But you always knew that you'd be the one to work while they all play. And you'd lay awake at night and scheme of all the things that you would change, but it was just a dream.
Okay, it looks like we are loading into this game now.
Yeah. Welcome back from that intermission. And it does look like Draven coming out with the Ghost and Cleanse. Really interesting combo of summoner spells for him, actually. What are your thoughts on that?
Yeah, it really shows that he's got faith in his support. I mean, Draven with the Ghost, already his W is giving him some movement speed, so the Ghost will just make him even faster, maybe put him in that hyper carry position, but without heal and without flash, he's pretty fragile in team fights. Mm-hmm. He has to rely a lot on Morgana.
And I do see a lot of standard keystones coming out for both teams. I do like the phase rush on the Vladimir. It gives a lot of teamfight presence. You're able to chase down those last few kills with that phase rush. But I would like to see maybe a Kleptomancy Vladimir sometime in the future.
Kleptomancy with Cole giving a lot of gold lead early in the game. But phase rush is always a good option to choose as well with that burst of movement speed you get from just using three spells. And Vladimir can get up to those three spells pretty quickly. Mm-hmm.
And I'm really interested to see in this top lane matchup, we're going to have to see if Teemo lands those crucial blinds right as the Pantheon jumps on him for the W empowered. But we'll just have to see how this matchup plays out. And we do see he goes Grasp of the Undying. He's looking for a farm lane, looking to get a bit tanky for the late game.
Yeah, Teemo, a lot of different builds that he could go with. So only time will tell really with what he goes with. You go full AP or you could go tank with Frozen Mallet. All depends on what he's feeling and how the lane's playing out.
And a very standard jungle start from both teams. They're starting at the red, looking to path up top. No risky invades this game. And it looks like they're probably going to play towards late as they're not looking for any early advantages from the early game.
Yes, and just trades going around here. CS being picked up for both.
We do see Sejuani and Ekko. They have differing jungle paths. Ekko going for the Krugs rather than the Wolves. Looks like Sejuani will be able to reach the top side of the map before Ekko does. And we'll see if she can turn that into a gank on the top lane or a gank in the mid lane.
Yeah, Sejuani level 2 has pretty high ganking potential. Level 3 eventually will come around for her to just make a gank on wherever she chooses. Bot lane CSing. Morgana stepping up here possibly to land a Dark Binding. Throws it out, lands on the Leona. Varus taking a lot of damage under fire. And it looks like First Blood goes out to the Draven. And now Trade's going out on top lane as well with the Pantheon and Teemo. And great Dark Binding from that Morgana. Looking on the Leona, she had no way to follow up against the damage that was coming out on the Varus there.
Mm-hmm. And Varus holds on to his flash. And that's honestly a very great start for the Draven. Able to pick up that early First Blood kill. And he might look to get an early BF as well. It looks like he's backing now, not opting to stay in the lane after that first kill. Let's see what he purchases as his first few items.
Yeah, able to pick up maybe a longsword or a dagger. Oh, able to actually purchase the Vamp Scepter already, giving that good early lifesteal.
Not only will he be able to now snowball, he has a lot of lifesteal for that Varus poke that will eventually come out when Varus does level up to level 3 or level 4.
Yeah, and you're seeing some actually early lane dominance from the Pantheon and not the Teemo this time. Maybe Grassman dying. Using Pantheon looking to contest his Scuttlecrab, doing a little bit of damage to the Echo, but Echo returns with quite a big burst of damage. E comes out negating the rest of what Echo's combo would do. Pantheon and, recalling.
Yeah, a little bit of a misstep there from Pantheon. He wasn't able to predict how much damage that Echo would do with that Dark Harvest, and gets punished for it.
Yeah, now Echo returning to the jungle to take Grom.
And interestingly enough, Vladimir with the CS lead over the Ahri in the mid lane here, able to just out-heal her damage that she puts out.
And now the bot, Leona, playing pretty safe now, doesn't want to get binded again. Could result in another kill for Draven, making him 2-0, possibly snowballing the lane into a pretty dangerous situation. Now Draven walking up. Darkbinding lands on the Varus. Looks like he's going to be going down. Nothing he can really do there. Leona forced to walk away.
And this is a very rough lane for that Leona. She's unable to make plays as there is always the threat of that Darkbinding as well as that Black Shield. And she can't really do anything when they do go on her AD carry.
Yeah, now you see Sejuani kind of playing around with the Scuttlecrab, but it looks like Echo's going to be able to pick that up. Big wave of minions crashing into the tower for the red side.
And I do like how Echo is prioritizing these Scuttlecrabs. It's going to be a lot harder for Burn Creek Silver to make moves around the map, to rotate, help out that bot lane a little bit. And just overall great map control from Gladstone right here.
And you can see this Teemo now overextending.
Pantheon does jump on him, but the binding comes through and the empowered or the Q execution damage was just too much for the Teemo, and he just goes down right there. Teemo does burn the ignite, and Pantheon, however, is able to keep both summoners up.
Yeah, you can see the Teemo not able to return the amount of damage that the Pantheon is putting out, possibly grasping the Undying Rune, looking for a more sustainable approach. Maybe not wanting to take these early fights, build up to late game and maybe scale that way.
And we do see Pantheon with the CS lead as well. Looking to snowball that lane perhaps now with this one kill. Let's see if he can turn that into global map pressure for the rest of his team with that Pantheon ult at level 6.
Yeah, Pantheon's ult just from the top lane barely has to leave lane actually to ult mid. So Vladimir might have to watch out here. Seems to be sustaining pretty well though against his Ahri. Near
it looks
full
like
health.
Pantheon. He might be making some moves on the bot side as he is pathing down. Let's see if he ults.
Yeah, ult is online. Maybe looking. Bot lane seems to be pretty close to their tower, though. Possibly they know that he's coming.
However, there is that, as I said again, the Morgana Black Shield is very strong. Oh, looks like they're
looking
going
early
aggressive. Pantheon looking to ult in. Ults right behind them, but Draven just walking up, auto-attacking the Varus, he goes down. Draven gets empowered, cute, as he goes down as well. Now the chase on Morgana, flash on the Leona, gets the Zenith Blade, but doesn't land the stun because of the Black Shield, and Morgana walks out alive. And
now Morgana can stay.
Oh, looks like there is another fight as Morgana lands the Binding. Echo coming in from the side lands the stun as well. Looks like he's going to tough this out. He does have ultimate. Looking for the chase on the Leona. Doesn't get it. Has the ult to safety as Pantheon is jumping on the Echo and runs out the execute damage from Pantheon's Q. Not quite enough there.
Yeah, and Pantheon really looking for these early game kills on the Echo. You can really see the early game power that he brings to this team. And Teemo pushing up.
Yep.
And mid lane still looking like an even trade here.
Yeah. And I do like the attempt from Burn Creek Silver there to try and rescue that bottom lane. However, that Draven doing so much damage, able to just walk up to that Varus and chunk him down. A very unfortunate fight for Burn Creek Silver. However, they are taking the right steps to try and shut down this Draven in the bottom lane.
Yeah, a lot of attention is going to have to be put towards this Draven before he snowballs out of control, especially with these interesting summoner spells now. Cleansing Ghost looking pretty scary now that he has that lead.
Yeah, and Draven flexing that he doesn't even need the flash to win this lane. Looks like Pantheon just goes for the ranged Q. Might look for a fight right here. Jumps in on the Teemo, stuns him, gets a little bit of a trade there. It doesn't look like he'll be able to kill that Teemo. Looking a bit tanky.
Yeah, now Teemo just recovering from this. Grass of the Undying actually providing quite enough sustain for him to stay in this lane. But Pantheon's looking for a roam mid, as you can see on the map.
His ultimate is not up, however. Looks like he might just try and spot that Echo, give information to the bot side so that they can play more aggressively without fear of an Echo gank coming through.
And now Pantheon coming in on this Vladimir in the mid lane. He does have pull up. He might be able to get stunned up and charmed. No time for him to pull. He just goes straight down here.
And that was just beautiful layering of CC right there. Able to time that charm with the Pantheon stun, not allowing any time for the Vladimir to pull out. And we do see Morgana getting those nice, nice stacks on that Spell Thieves. She's able to land the stun or the binding as well as the pull. And a slight reset from the Burn Creek Silver here, as they do look to come back to these lanes. A bit stronger, the Ahri now with the kill, has Lost Chapter, has that Blasting Wand. We'll see what she can do with it.
And now the Sejuani becoming a little bit more tanky here, clearing these minions here in the top lane. Sejuani really comes online after she gets that Cinderhulk, picks up those early tank stats.
And I do like to point out that although both junglers have been mainly farming, the Echo did come bot lane and help. However, the jungle cleared by Echo just enough to out farm the Sejuani, and now has a slight bounty on him as well.
And Echo looking for a fight here in the mid. There's on the W, but no luck there.
And just small skirmishes that this Echo is looking for in the mid lane. Unable to get anything from it. Looks like they do see the Sejuani pathing towards the top side. Teemo able to just walk away right there, has those Teemo shrooms up, and will be able to deter many jungle ganks on him.
Yeah, and Teemo picking up that early ninja tabby to negate a lot of the damage that Pantheon's dishing out. Pretty smart pick from him.
And it looks like
and now Echo looking for a tower dive here. Echo landing the W right in the middle of the tower. Stun does not come out, but the burst of damage. Leona's ult comes out, stunning two of them. Now Echo recharging, and then Draven going down to the tower. Morgana getting out with just a very little amount of health, but both bot laners go down in this skirmish.
And that was really well played. Actually more action in the mid lane as Pantheon seems to be trying to duel the Vladimir, unable to outdamage his heal, however, has to back off.
Yeah, and a pretty good dive on their part. Draven does go down from the turret aggro, but still picking up two kills over one.
And now it looks like Burn Creek Silver looking to get this dragon, as they did have a lot of bot priority. As Gladstone did reset off that bot plane dive. However, it looks like they do back off the dragon, as Morgana does show it provides a lot of pressure from the backside of the pit. Teemo, meanwhile, in the top lane, just
with
getting these plates, is able to build up a lot of gold from those plates, and we'll see if he can turn that into a late game monster.
Yeah, it's looking like a tank Teemo build here for him, trading a little bit of damage with the Pantheon, but more or less looking for plate gold rather than Pantheon gold. So,
and we'll
have
to
see. Safe.
Yeah, we'll have to see if Burn Creek is able to accelerate this game and get as many objectives as possible before the Pantheon eventually does kind of fall off in the late game, unable to, you know, really lock down anyone in terms of team fights.
Yeah, and you can see that still 12 minutes in, both mid laners evenly trading, only kills coming out from ganks that were done, but still they're fending off of each other pretty evenly. Sustain from both laners, the REQ heal, as well as the Vladimir healing all around. It's making this lane pretty much a stalemate.
And I do want to see perhaps a Morello's early from the Ahri, as Draven does seem to be going in down there in the bot lane. Doesn't get too much out of that. Varus does hold the flash, is able to have it up for the next switch.
Vladimir looking for a little early game hook, is charmed under tower. Ahri's Q comes out, isn't enough damage, ults forward, gets hit by the Vladimir ult, but it's not enough. I believe Ignite Tick took down the Vladimir there before the end damage come out. And now Echo flashing forward to secure that final kill on the Ahri, who's living with just a sliver of health from that Vladimir ultimate. Good capitalization on that recall.
And very nice play coming from that Echo, able to salvage the solo kill that Ahri did get on the Vladimir. But we'll have to see if she can do anything with that Ludens and those two kills. We'll see if she's able to roam around the map, help out that Pantheon a little bit more, get a solo kill on the Vladimir again, or even help out their bot lane as well.
And you can see the bot lane tower is now gone. Draven sitting on a lot of gold here. 30 CS up, roughly, over this Varus.
And I do like that the Sejuani has been farming a lot. She's trying to get those items, trying to get tanky. So when the mid game does come around and they have to team fight, she'll be able to frontline most of the damage coming from Draven, coming from the Teemo, coming from the Echo. And we'll see if that is enough to turn the fight favor into Burn Creek. But it looks like there's a little bit of action in the mid lane. Both CC missing from the mid and top laners respectively.
Spear missing too. No damage really coming out on that. Vladimir easily escapes with nothing to really lose there. Sejuani now trying to defend this topside tower by herself. There's not really much she can do.
Yeah.
And now Sejuani trying to clear the waves out while Draven is applying great pressure here in the bot lane, or in the top lane.
And meanwhile, on the bot side, the bottom. Duo of Burn Creek Silver just unable to answer the push from the top side.
And now Draven's tower comes up, a Pantheon ulting in, the cleanse does come out, and as well as the spell shield, they're getting all CC that is possible. Draven actually ulting in to destroy this Sejuani here, looking for a kill, picks it up, and now Sejuani going down to the Echo, who returns the counter gank here.
And, oh, looks like there's more action
here. Echo ulting away into safety, and now the Leona going in with the Varus as well. The support ult comes out. He is snared up and stunned. Will Teemo go down here? Runs away. Not enough. The ignite ticks, and now Leona picks up the kill on the Teemo.
And honestly, that was quite a good initiation on the top side for Burn Creek Silver. However, it did not have vision on the top side of the map. They did not see that Echo was hovering the Draven as well as the Morgana, and they took a pretty bad fight there because of lack of vision control.
Yeah, and I could see what the Pantheon was trying to do in the top lane there with that ult. Him being 2-0 at that current point in time was trying to pick up that kill on the Draven to get the shutdown gold, but Echo coming up and returning the gank. Just not enough damage coming out from Burn Creek Silver right now to take out that Draven. You can see the cleanse and the Morgana spell shield really doing wonders against that CC that they were trying to chain on the Draven.
And I really want to point out that instead of finishing his Bloodthirster, Draven opts for the double IE. He'll be doing explosive damage in the mid lane right now.
Yeah, double IE. Pretty aggressive play from here, but he is extremely ahead and maybe wants to finish his game out. Now Echo looking to trade some damage with Sejuani, but she is pretty tanky at this point and gets out with a little over half her health. And now Cloudrake looking to be picked up here for Gladstone.
And just no answer from Burn Creek, as if they do take a fight, they will lose a lot of objectives from that. So.
Echo looking for an early stun on the Sejuani, able to dash away. You see those tank stats really working out for Sejuani here, able to dodge all of this invade into her jungle.
And I do want to see a bit more resources being dumped into the Varus, as he is very strong in the late game. Oh, looks like Vladimir going
looking
in! Teemo playing! Is he able to kill with Teemo? Like, does get the kill! Is he able to escape? Does have his face rush up. Goes for the E, doesn't have the pull, and gets shut down by Ahri right there.
Now Gladstone looking to return with a Rift Herald take.
Yeah, and that was some beautiful macro decisions as, oh, they saw that they sent three members after the Vladimir. Let's just go top and take the Rift Herald. And let's see if they can convert it into more gold for Gladstone here, as they do have the Herald. However, most of the plates are gone on the map.
And you can really see that explosive damage coming out from Vladimir. Him being 1-3, but still actually being able to take out with the Hemo Plague. Amplify all the damage.
And it looks like Gladstone has majority of the vision control on the map. A very scary place to be if you're Burn Creek Silver, unable to know where the enemies are. And I believe that they do have the Pantheon Global Ult. They need more vision if they want to make plays around the map.
Yeah, really. Charm actually lands on the Draven. Spell Shield coming out to dodge some CC, but will it be enough? Draven actually turning the fighting. Ari, but Pantheon coming in. Cleanse comes out. Not enough. Draven goes down. Morgana running for her life. Pantheon looking for more. We have Sejuani coming around from the corner. He's ulting into the mid lane. I believe misses, does the damage. It doesn't even matter. Sejuani and Leona able to pick up the kill against Morgana.
And a bit of a misstep right there for Gladstone. Walking up too far, not knowing if the Pantheon was around the area to ult, if the Sejuani was going to come mid either, and they get shut down right there.
Now Sejuani looking for more on this Teemo, who's quite overextended, but looking like she misses her Q. Teemo play coming out, actually, looking like a solo kill on the Varus in the bot lane. Happened so fast, we didn't even get to see it.
And that Vladimir, very strong right now, has that Proto Bell. Looks like to be building the Rabadon's Death Cap right after that. Able to just solo kill the Varus. And it does look like Gladstone having a lot of explosive damage. Theana goes in on the Vladimir, lands and it's done. Misses the ultimate, but here comes Pantheon, and here comes Ahri. Misses the charm, gets the W, however. Looks like they're just brawling it out. Vladimir with the charge up E. Theana goes down to the Vladimir in the end. Vladimir still looking to chase, perhaps. No, too dangerous, as Ahri and Pantheon do have their hard stuns up.
And a great stun by Echo, stunning both of the opposing team on Burn Creek Silver there. Now looking to contest this Rift Crab that's coming into the mid lane here.
Ooh,
oh, and an explosion of damage, but not enough, actually. Echo going down, thinking that he could burst out the Ahri, but she gets out with just a little bit of health.
Yeah, and she lands that charm on him. He wasn't able to ult because he was CC so hard. Looks like Morgana might be looking for... Oh,
no vision.
Just barely.
And now both lanes, top and mid, being pushed.
And it looks like Gladstone wanting to break the base right here, trying to get this middle inhibitor turret. Did they get extend too far? No. Sejuani misses the ultimate, and Draven and Morgana able to just walk away.
Yeah, and you can see this Teemo 0-2, but still doing a number on these turrets in the top lane with his Demolish. And now you can see Burn Creek grouping around the bot lane, not really sure which lane to contest as all of them are kind of crashing into their base at the same time.
And with this Draven so far ahead, I wouldn't be surprised if Gladstone called for an early Baron right here.
Yeah, they definitely could take it with that. And forcing a fight wouldn't be too bad either, as you've seen countless times that they have actually won. Dark Binding comes out in the Pantheon, but I don't think she'll be going for anything more than that. Tower in the bot lane goes down now.
Yeah, and this is such a hard game for Burn Creek Silver, as that Vladimir and that Teemo just split pushing the lanes right there. And they weren't able to answer with 1v1s, so they had to send both the bot laners down there to try to stop that Vladimir.
And Dark Binding landing on the Pantheon, blocking out the recall, stun coming out as well for the Echo. Pantheon going down. Sejuani looking to return some CC, but forced to run away from the Teemo who is flanking on the right side.
And those Dark Bindings are getting Gladstone so ahead in this game. They're just finding pick after pick after pick.
Yeah, and you can see that Pantheon actually wanting to recall, thinking he was safe, but Dark Binding lands. You're snared for 3 seconds, and sadly he goes down.
And it looks like Gladstone is going to take control over the second Drake. It will be Infernal. They will do a lot more damage.
Yeah, and maybe looking for... Oh, and you can see that the Infernal will be coming up again after that. So,
we'll
two Infernals coming out for Gladstone would be huge. Draven's damage would be amplified significantly in the next fights.
We'll have to see what Burn Creek Silver try to do to get themselves back into this game.
I still believe that they could funnel some damage from the Pantheon here.
They do have a very... team fight CC oriented team, so I do want to see them try to go for those 5v5s, protect the Varus in the background as he does do damage, and we'll see if they get any vision on this Baron.
And it looks like a Baron is starting for Gladstone here.
not really much that Burn Creek Silver can do in this situation. Might just have to let it go. Vladimir taking three people against one. Looking like he's actually going to win a trade against the Ahri. Sejuani coming in to pick up the last minute kill against Vladimir, but now the Baron. Pantheon actually ulting in to take it. Does not land a secure on it and goes down. Good attempt though on the Baron steal.
And that was a very good attempt from the Pantheon. He does ult in, but sadly was not able to take the Baron away from Gladstone.
And I respect him for those picks.
Running in with the Mercurial Scimitar, looking for that Varus pick. However, Varus just able to walk away.
And I respect that play by the Pantheon. Really, it's a do-or-die situation currently in the state of the game. Sejuani looking for some picks on the Teemo, able to flash away to safety, running away into the nest of his shrooms.
Yeah. And this is very hard as they do have that Teemo, as I said, up there split pushing constantly. The Vladimir in the bot lane split pushing constantly, able to go for one for one trades, even if they do send three down there in the bot lane for him. And it looks like Gladstone is in full control of this game at the moment.
Yeah, the options for Burn Creek are slowly slipping away. They might have to capitalize on picks such as this on the Morgana, who's clearing vision in the Raptor pit.
Yeah, however, that Sejuani alone, though. That Dark Biting, able to just hold him there for 3 seconds, Sejuani unable to do anything.
Now taking the blue buff away.
We'll see if they can go for a pick here. I really want to see the Pantheon, the Ahri, landing the hard CC for picks. Oh, looks like there's some action right here as Ahri lands the charm on the Teemo. However, has to walk away. Teemo just a bit too tanky for her at the moment.
And now you can see fight ensuing. Actually, Leona jumping in but not wanting to commit to anything as this Vladimir is doing such a big burst of damage. Draven actually looking for some auto attacks. The ult comes to pick up a kill on the Leona. They might be able to push the base here.
And this might be, looks like they're backing off, opting to push out the bot lane instead. However, Vladimir, hovering around that mid side, is able to make so much pressure, having his ultimate up as well.
Yeah, Draven hovering bot side, the other team member is actually pushing mid, still flashing in, bursting down the Ahri. Will it be enough? Uses all three charges of her ult to escape, and now Vladimir in the pool heals enough to maybe escape. Two tower shots hit him, but it's not enough. He actually is managing to escape that fight. So Sejuani looking to do what she can against this team, but now bot lane tower coming on, the bot lane inhibitor going down. And as you can see, the top lane Teemo split pushing the top. It's looking like a triple inhibitor for Gladstone.
And right now, Burn Creek Silver have no answer for this Vladimir. It's way too hard to kill. Oh, it looks like Panther going in, just getting bursted out. Leona landing the Zenith Blade is able to stay alive a little bit. No, just gets chunked down by the Draven. Draven going for that triple kill, going for the base. It looks like the quadra kill was taken away from him by the Echo, and it looks like this is the game for Gladstone.
And just nothing they could do at the end. The Draven and the Vladimir just got online way too fast for them to do anything about it.
Oh, it looks like Gladstone just ran that game the entire time. They did have a lot of map pressure. Their solo laners were very strong, and it looks like that bot lane Draven was able to just snowball the game into their favor.
Yeah, and the Teemo originally thought to have been somewhat dominant, thinking that Pantheon was taking actually an early lead, but it wasn't enough just Pantheon alone. Too many people on the enemy team were just way too fed for him to contest it.
Yep. And quite an unfortunate game for Burn Creek Silver. I did like their draft, however, I do believe their play was a bit poor in the bot lane. They did give that Draven a couple of kills early, and that led to the snowball for Gladstone.
Yeah, and you can really see the confidence, as I said in the earlier part of the game. He did have a lot of confidence with the support. It showed the cleanse coming out with the Morgana and Black Shield, negating basically all CC that ever came towards him, especially once he picked up the QSS and Mercurial Scimitar.
Really just able to run down the entire team without any fear.
And that was quite the game for both, as Gladstone does play the superior game.
And what did you think about the Vladimir versus Ahri lane early in the game? Do you think that Ahri maybe could have done something else to change the game?
Yeah, I think Vladimir in lane is pretty manageable. I think they should have sent the Sejuani mid lane, probably tried to get some kills on that Vladimir early, get the Ahri more ahead. Although I did see a couple of ganks coming in from the Pantheon. I didn't really see a lot of map pressure generated by that Sejuani. She seemed to just farm most of the game and wasn't able to do much in the mid game, as that Draven just took over after getting double IE.
Yeah, it really was just Draven's game. Nothing really they could have done against it once he started rolling.
Mm-hmm. Does seem.
And you can also see the Teemo's KDA 0-2-1 here. One kill participation for the Teemo. However, he took that entire top side by himself.
Mm-hmm. That split push Teemo, putting a lot of pressure on the top side of the map. Having the Vladimir bottom as well, able to potentially just 2v1. It didn't seem like there was much of a chance for Burn Creek right there to have an answer to both of them at the same time.
Yeah, just unfortunate series of events for Burn Creek here.
Yeah, and that early kill, as I said earlier, did snowball the Draven. The gold lead was heavily in favor of Gladstone for most of the game. I believe the entirety of the game. Really hard for Burn Creek Silver to claw their way back into the game with these minute picks that they got. And as I said earlier, the Pantheon late game just wasn't enough for them.
Yeah, there were a few early game options for Burn Creek to actually come back into the game, but they slowly just kind of slipped away. And I believe that on Papa Smurfin's side, he should have shown a little bit more of this lane priority. He was watching the Echo run around the lanes, but was kind of just sitting there waiting for something to happen. But I feel like Papa Smurfin never really looking for these openings.
Yep, and does look like that is it. So we will catch you guys next time on the Rift.
Thank you for watching.
Thank you for watching.